Okay, what's up YouTube? I am back. Another episode, another day. Today's gonna be a little slightly different. It's gonna be another review video, and I just wanna get this one out there, you know, cause I've been using this rod for my frogs and my cheaters that I've been tossing out there, and I want you guys to know exactly what rod I'm throwing it on. And that rod is a Skinner Swim Bait Series rod. This is a 786, so it's 7 feet, 8 inches, and I guess it's a 6 power. I think that's what the 6 stands for. So 786 Skinner Swim Bait Series rod. Some specs about the rod is that it has a 13 inch handle. I'm pretty sure it's 13 inches. I haven't measured it, but I'm pretty sure it's 13 inches. The reason being for that is so that way when you're skipping your cheater or throwing your frog into the toolies or whatever, when you go to set the hook, when you're holding it, it should be like right about there in your armpit. So that way when you set the hook, the butt of this goes into your armpit, and then you can get that perfect hook set that you want. Versus it being a shorter handle, you'll just miss your armpit, and the hook set will be doo-doo, and the odds of you hooking into that fish is decreases a lot. It has a Fuji seat right here, which is I think is a good brand. It's all made very nicely down here. It has a very good grip, very good handle. It's very, very stout, you know. Another spec about the rod is that, I'll show this in another clip down below. I put it on a table so that way you guys can see. And I'm just gonna like put a voiceover over what's going on right there. So as you can see, just pick my nose, all crusty, huh? As you can see, the rods right here, the eyes start to spin. It's a something wrap. It's like a spinning wrap on the rod with the eyes, or the whatever you want to call those things. But they spin downward like that, so therefore makes the backbone on the top of the rod like a spinning rod almost. This is an extra heavy rod, so with a fast tip, or not fast tip, what is it? Fast action. I just got into, you know, like all the moderate fast action, things like that. I'm not too familiar with them, so I'm just gonna tell you guys what I know. So everything I'm telling you guys now is what I know. It's like, it's not information. It's information that I have accumulated throughout, you know, the months of using rods and everything and watching videos and things like that. So I'm not like an expert on any of this stuff, so you guys can go ahead and critique me and say whatever you want, give feedback, I appreciate that. But but this is what I know. So I believe the backbone would be on top of the rod like a spinning rod, because the eyes they face downward, and you'll see that down below. Again, it's just here's another angle of the rod, you know, here's another view of the eyes on the rod. There's not too many rods out there made like that. This rod right here is specially designed to throw the cheater with it, if that makes any sense. So this rod was created specifically to skip the cheater or use the cheater swim bait. If you do not have a cheater swim bait, I recommend you do get one. You could throw it on any rod, but this rod right here specifically is for the cheater. I do recommend you get like a heavy action rod to throw the cheater, because it's actually, you know, it's got some weight to it. And I have snapped one. I've caught a 6.8 on the cheater on an Abu Garcia rod, and then the very next cast I snapped the rod. Here's that fish. You guys can look at that. And I actually snapped that rod that I caught that fish with. So after that, I didn't want to buy another Abu Garcia rod, because it was just too cheap, you know, like, I don't know, it was an extra heavy rod and it snapped and it shouldn't have done that. And that sucks, you know, and I couldn't get that replaced. But this rod right here so far has done me justice, and I think, I know a lot of, Billy Skinner, the guy who created this rod, he's boat flipped a 14 pound fish, and his buddy Ben flipped a 12 pound fish this year. And a couple other guys, you know, they boat flip eight pounders, 9 pounders. You could go on Billy's. I recommend you guys go on Billy Skinner's Facebook page and you guys watch his videos, because he catches some pretty giant fish with this rod and this bait that he created. And he bounces them. He just like all out, just grabs it from right here, and then just boat flips the fish. I haven't been fishing it that long, so I wouldn't like really, I haven't caught big fish like that. So one day I will though, like this, I know this summer I'm gonna get some good footage of me bouncing some big fish in, because that's what I really hope I'm doing, so that way I can actually really test the rod. It's a very well designed rod. Spent a couple $100s on this. Usually I don't go out and just buy rods because I'm not that into it. I'm a bang fisherman trying to get on boats now, so as a bang fisherman you don't really carry like a cranking rod, a flipping rod, all these rods that you could fish different water with because you're just fishing the bank. So this is my first big purchase of a rod, and so far I'm enjoying it a lot. It's 7'8", and I think the length is perfect on it for throwing this bait, because you get it way back into that nasty stuff, and then you gotta pull it out, and you want to kind of horse the fish in, so that way that tension isn't loosened up or anything, so that way the fish doesn't come unpinned. You really want to keep that fish pinned, or else you'll just lose it every time. I've had a couple do that. But for the most part, this rod is so far amazing. I love it. Other rods that are made like this with the spinning wrap, they're not so great. They're not so firm. They're a lot weaker, and I know of a lot of them that have been breaking. I mean, all rods break, don't get me wrong. But this rod right here, so far, is doing me good. But other rods, with, like I said before, with that spinning action on the eyes, they just break. So I wouldn't recommend getting one unless it's a Skinner rod. I just wanted to share that with you guys so that way you guys know what I'm throwing when you guys see my fishing videos. But that's really all I have. That's the review on this rod. I give it a 10 out of 10 so far. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I hope you guys enjoy these reviews. I hope to do more in the future on baits and line and how to tie knots and everything, because you know I want to share the information that I learned out with you guys. So I thank you guys all for the positive comments and the feedback and everything. Even if it's a negative comment, you know, I go based off of that. I read all your guys' comments. I see people that are, you know, active on there, and I really appreciate it, you know, because that helps me learn as a fisherman and as a person and as a videographer. What can I do to get better? Because I'm always trying to get better. I'm trying to better myself. But yeah, that's it, guys. I appreciate you guys watching my videos, you guys hitting that like button, and you guys subscribing to my YouTube channel, because there's thousands more videos that I'm gonna take and minutes of video that I'm gonna take. So it's only gonna go from here. So I appreciate you guys watching and, you know, supporting me. But with all that being said, guys, I'd like to thank you all for watching. Have a great weekend, and remember, guys, fish on. Oh, oh, oh.